Hi guys, we have already seen the introduction of this topic, fire insurance claim, and in this video I'm going to solve some problems on fire insurance claim. This is the first problem and it's a simple problem. Okay, in this question here it is said that fire occurred in the business premises of a trader on 1/7/2013 and entire stock was destroyed. Okay, however, the books and records were saved and the following information was obtained. They have given us stock. This is the opening stock and this is the closing stock, 35 and 40,000. And they have also given us the purchases for the year ending 31/12/2012. Okay, so this purchases is from previous year and this sales is also from previous year. And so all these four, we will take this in trading account. Okay, and these two we will take is in the memorandum trading account, because this is from the current year, that is till the date of fire 36/2013. So we will take these two in the memorandum trading account. Okay, now first we'll prepare the trading account, then we'll prepare the memorandum trading account, then we'll prepare the statement of fire claim to find out how much stock was destroyed in fire and what will be the final amount of claim that has to be compensated by the insurance company. So we need to prepare first trading account. First we'll write two opening stock. In the question it is given 35,000. That is, we will take the purchases here on the debit side of trading account, two purchases, and the amount is purchases for the year ending 31/12/2012. That is 80,000. Okay, 80,000. Okay, now we'll take sales. Buy sales, always sales will come on the credit side of trading account, okay, and the purchase is on debit side. So sales for year 2012 is 1 lakh. Then buy closing stock will come on the credit side of trading account, that is for the year ended 2012, and that is 40,000. Okay, all four of these are given in the question. Okay, credit side is bigger, which will be 1,40,000. 1,40,000. I'm balancing now. We will find gross profit over here. Gross profit. 1,40,000 minus 35 minus 80. That is 25,000. Okay. Alright. We have found the gross profit. Now, after finding the gross profit, we need to find GP rate. Now you will say, what is GP rate? GP rate is GP, that is gross profit, divided by sales into 100. Now you will say, why we need to find GP rate? We need to find GP rate to find the gross profit in the memorandum trading account. Okay, so we'll find the GP rate. 25,000 divided by 1 lakh, that is the sales, into 100, that gives us 25%. Okay, now after creating trading account and finding the gross profit, then finding the GP rate, we will open memorandum trading account. Okay, and this account is prepared to find closing stock on the date of fire. Remember, on the date of fire. Okay, so to find closing stock, we already need gross profit, that we will find by GP rate. Okay, so first we'll take two opening stock. In the question there is no such opening stock, so we will take this closing stock as the opening stock here. Okay, so that is 40,000. Okay, then there is purchases. it's given in the question, purchases till the date of fire, and that is 37,000. Purchases always debit, then there's sales by sales always credit. It's also given in the question, sales till the date of fire, and that is 60,000. Okay, then there's gross profit. Now, how will we find gross profit? Gross profit is, that is 25% GP rate. So 25% of sales, 60,000 into 25 by 100. Okay, so that gives us 15,000. Easy, right? Okay, then this side has to be bigger. Okay, this side is 92,000. Then we will balance and find closing stock by closing stock, and this closing stock is till the date of fire. So now closing stock is a balancing figure, and 92,000 minus 60,000, that is 32,000. Okay, so easy, right? Okay, so now let's prepare the statement of fire claim. Okay, so first we'll write here closing stock. We'll take the closing stock on the date of fire. This closing stock we found in the memorandum trading account. Okay, so the amount was 32,000 closing stock on the date of fire, and the date also we must write, that is 36/2013 as given in the question. Then we will subtract the value of stock salvaged. This is a way to find the amount of claim. So what does the salvage mean? Salvage is nothing but the amount of stock that was saved from the fire. Okay, it's a simple term. Okay, then we will find the amount of claim. Amount of claim. Okay, so 32,000 minus value of stock salvaged. There's no such amount given in the question, so we'll just put the dash and we'll take it as a nil, and 32,000 minus 0 is 32,000. Okay, so the amount of claim is 32,000. What does this mean? It means that on this date there was 32,000 worth of stock in the business premises and all of it was burned. Okay, so the amount should be 30,000 equal to the loss incurred. Okay, at first we prepared the trading account. Okay, the opening stock, purchases, buy sales, closing stock, all these four were given in the question. Okay, and as a balancing figure we found out the gross profit, that was 25,000, and this 25,000 and the sales 1 lakh we applied to this formula to find out the GP rate, GP by sales into 100, and we got 25%. Okay, next we prepared the memorandum trading account. We prepared this account to find closing stock. The opening stock we got it from the trading accounts, closing stock. Okay, and purchases and sales were given in the question. Now gross profit, we needed the gross profit to find the closing stock. So gross profit, we took 25% of sales, this sales. Okay, so 25% is the GP rate we found out after the trading account, and we found out the closing stock till the date of fire, 32,000. After preparing the memorandum trading account, we prepared statement of fire claim, and first we wrote the closing stock which we found out in the memorandum trading account. Then we subtracted it from the value of stock salvaged, which was 0, so 32,000 minus 0 is 32,000. So the amount of claim is 32,000. Okay, easy, right? All right.